All right, I'm back. And it took me like an extra minute or two because a package came. So I ran out and grabbed it real quick. And I guess I'll show you it. So yesterday I got the collector's edition for Star Wars The Old Republic. It was $17 on eBay, and the guy shipped it, and I've been so impressed because the statue itself goes for like $70. And then I put this thing on my wish list, but then the person selling it sent me an offer that I couldn't refuse because it was like $10 cheaper, so it was like perfect. So I ended up getting it's Sam Fisher from, it's kind of hard to see, but it's Splinter Cell. It's I need to take it out, this thing. I think I will at least. But it's a Sam Fisher statue from Splinter Cell Blacklist, because apparently that's the only one that they have. So with that, I was like, yeah, I think that's worth it. Let me see if I can. What's going on, Living Legend? You can kind of see him. Like, he has the glasses on, or whatever, the goggles and stuff. So I think this one was like $15, but it's a lot more common than the Darth Malgus statue that I got, which I'll actually grab that real quick. So this is the collector's edition of Star Wars The Old Republic. And it has all the stuff inside of it, except for the collector's code, which lets you see the collector's store game. But my favorite part, and the reason I got it, is this guy right here. It's a Darth Malgus statue, and I think it's so dope. It's like pretty good condition too. This was used, but like for the condition, it's pretty good. It looks dope. Like, it's decent size. Like, here's my hand, and here's the statue. So it's pretty cool size. The only issue with it is the lightsaber on the other side. You can't really see it, and it's too close, but like the one piece broke off. But besides that, it's pretty dope. For $17, it was worth it. This statue itself goes for like $70 on eBay. I'm so glad I got it. Like, it was random. It was so random. I literally just went on eBay and I was like, I'm just gonna look. Saw it had like 2 hours left, no bids on it. I bid the least amount they were asking for and won. Works for me. Going to play some VR in a minute, just expect you to die. I expect you to die, and it's so fun. Interesting. All right, so let's go ahead and start the last broadcast. This is Malik. Broadcasting once again from war-torn Pogoren. I was calm so far. You shots heard around the block, but you can rest assured we'll be there for you. to report and denounce, to say what needs to be said, a voice that remains unheard, another game that I need to play, your voice of Pogoren. The last broadcast. Day one. I'm looking forward to this one. I think this one looks a little bit better than the last one, and I think Ember. I'm not sure about the last one. Like the trailer didn't explain much, so we'll see. They gotta be working on This War of Mine too by now. Malik and Esma live in an abandoned broadcasting station. Malik used to work as a radio host. His wife jokes that mortar shells which destroyed their house has fulfilled his secret wish. Now he doesn't have to leave work at all. Although war scattered the radio crew to the four winds, Malik keep broadcasting that news. The news that Esma gathers during her searches for supplies. The words of truth he can deliver to the people of Pogoren are for him as much as a livelihood as food hard won by his wife. Their son, Adam, enlisted when the war broke out and no longer talk about him. Alright, so we should have. She sneaks quietly. I almost put those words together by accident. Nice. See, I like these scenarios because they give you a bunch of pre-built stuff a lot of the time. So we have water already. We have one of those, whatever it is, herbal stations. Let's grab this. Can we listen to some music? Try to listen to some useful information. Cool. That's some news. So from my understanding, we get to choose what gets pushed out on the radio, since he's the radio host, which is pretty cool. Do we have a shovel already? Doesn't look like it. We might have to... Yeah, it looks like we might have to build one. Do we have a lockpick? Yeah, we do. Okay. I like how they at least start you with the lockpick. Open up the closet here. He's still listening to that. I have to look for news. Let's check this too. Okay, so we need a shovel in order to get to the other part of the room. Let's see if we can build. A workshop. Broadcast news. Recent news. Okay. So that's how you broadcast it. And just to make sure, yeah, it says 0 out of 1. Okay. So we can probably place it right there. Which is a pretty good area. I think that's everything. Besides, I mean, we can maybe pickaxe. Heaps of hard packed rubble. Oh. Do you need a pickaxe for this? We'll need one part in order to do that then. Huh. Let me just see what it says if I try going over to this. I should walk the city and look for some news. Need a pickaxe to remove the heaps of rubble. Okay. That's right. That's the end of the day. Yeah, so he can sleep, obviously. And should we go to the park, gas station, or ghost house? The men who live here, let's read the description. Park is considered relatively safe. There are no buildings to attract mortar barrages and availability. Searches, snipers. Okay. There had been a few hours long. Intended to clean the whole area from civilians, but it was broken. Many people died. But neither side claimed responsibility to this day. Despite heavy shelling of the whole district, the station is surprisingly in decent shape. It may have been looted, but there might be worth checking out. Okay. Huge amount of parts. Men who lived there used to give shelter to people in need. Either died or fled after his home has been ravaged by mortar fire. Since then, the house stands abandoned, and neighborhood kids say it's been haunted. Let's go to the gas station. A huge amount of parts. Won't take anything right now. People had it drained it dry since it blew up after the shelling. Of it. So this is the same gas station from the last mission, or the last DLC. Might be nearby, I must be careful. Uh-oh. Really? Actually, though? Kidding me? Supply truck. Oh, I see it. Yeah, it's all the way over there. Military papers, looks like supplies manifest. This is kind of sketchy. Oh God. Is he 100% hostile? That's my biggest fear. I don't know if I can knock him out. And I'm kind of nervous too.
Oh no!
Got him. Slightly wounded. Alright, well, she'll heal up after that. Awesome. It's been hit. Judging by the markings, they contain military food. There's a truck, there's plenty of supplies on it, enough to help many sick and starving people. Starving and sick people. Awesome. Yeah, we'll definitely take them parts. I'm pretty sure we're the only other person here. But the problem is, they might bring more back up next time. Alright. There's stuff that we can come back here for, but I'm gonna go back to the area and let him know about the supplies then. This truck is full of supplies. We all desperately need Mallet broadcast this location to help many people survive. Why does it make it do that right there? Day 2. To us, a whole little gift at the gas station. She's sad, hungry, tired. Wait, somebody. No. I'm gonna have her rest up. And she's slightly wounded. Alright, let's have him broadcast it. Actually, wait, listen to it first. If there's nothing that comes up, then we'll just broadcast. Nobody has any news. So it sounds like you can probably get tips over the radio. And then you can choose where to go from there. A smoke calms me down. Okay. Is smoker an abstinent? Story related. Residents of Pogoren, good news. An army truck full of military rations and medical supplies is broken down at the gas station. Get your share before the military reclaims it. Nice. A gift to citizens of Pogoren. okay. What do we need to make? You can go down steps. Crap, I forget what we needed to make. Oh yeah, the pickaxe. Right, right. And you should probably get a knife too. I'm not gonna waste the bandage because you'll just recover from it. Okay, so we need three weapons, components. We're halfway through the day. Yeah, we can go over here. Damn it, it takes a while. Ow. So it sounds like, yeah, she's tired now. Huh. Do we still have that? Okay, yeah, we do. I'm gonna let her rest up, mainly because we need to use the, we need to get out for some more information. Lots of materials, lots of parts, lots of weapons. Yeah, let's go to the ghost house, I guess. Might as well. It's deserted. I don't expect to meet anyone inside. At least not anybody living. Oh, hey. Hello, don't be afraid. I just think I recognize you. Work over for the, you work for the radio, right? Yeah. I have something to say to you. Okay. I'll let you know how important you are to us. Thank you for letting us know about the truck with supplies. I desperately needed medicine for my daughter. I found some there. My little girl will live thanks to you. Wait, is that Adam? I think that's Adam. That's Adam. Yeah, that's 100% him. Check if there's any food, Angela. Yeah, that's him. Huh. I'm pretty sure that's him because he's wearing the same outfit and everything. If that is, that's actually really funny. It's an animal inside. Just a rat. Alright, so we need to find some good news or something. Instead of taking the wood and that, I'm gonna prioritize like the cigarettes and stuff for them. Just when I managed to reach this country, we thought it to be safe. It was plunged into the war. Okay. Need something to open this lock. Damn, we should have brought a lockpick. Lockpick or a crowbar. I mean, she's stealthy, so maybe a lockpick would be better for her. And I'm pretty sure we have one too. Oops, no, that's fine. I'll take the weapons parts over the sugar, actually. And take that back. We need a saw in order to get there. There's something down here. Saw blade. There's definitely something in here that we'll want to do. Oh, we already went through that. Debating whether to purchase this game. What's it similar to? What is it similar to? So what comes to mind for me? Number one, I'm gonna say it's worth it because it's literally like, I mean, if you're getting it on Steam, it's like $8, or you can get it on like Humble Bundle. And it's literally like $2 for the base game. And then the DLCs, if you really want all that, is like 99 cents for the children DLC. And then $2 for the stories DLC. What it's like though is, I mean, when you're out and about, it's like a survival scavenging stealth game in a way, and trading. But then when you're in the house, which I'm about to go back to, it's more of like a micromanage like Sims game in a way. So when you're inside the house, you choose who eats, you choose what actions happen, what items you're gonna build. But then when you go out at night, it's mainly like side-scrolling stealth. Personally, I've never really played a game similar to this. This is kind of like something that's a little bit further away from games I'd usually play. But they have like the choices matter and things like that, so that always really interests me. Nice. And like there's a lot of random events that can happen. Different things for different play sessions. There's a lot of replay value too. Personally, I 100% recommend it. I don't know really what else to compare it to, because it's kind of like its own game in a way. Okay, so we don't have a lockpick actually. Let me make one. And I'm gonna start bringing that with me places. I don't think we have a saw blade yet either, but I would like to craft one. Yeah, so we can't make one just yet. Can we upgrade this? We need parts and wood. All right, let's go chat with him. How much longer we can keep doing it. The army won't sit on their hands listening to our broadcasts. That's true, but this is the price of changing the situation in our city. It's worth it, my love. True. So, horrible letter, and nobody has ever threatened to kill Malik before. What should I do? He had to tell him. I hope our broadcast about the supply truck help some people. We're all in this together. We must aid each other however we can. Okay, good. So she already healed up a bit. Let's have him listen to the radio. So right now, I'm playing one of the second story DLC for this game. It's so tiring. Oh, she has to be fully healed in order to do it. Jeez. So in the first one, you play as a father trying to, help his daughter who's sick, and then she goes missing, and then you follow her and stuff. This one, you play as a couple who runs a radio station, and you're trying to help, the people. So you choose what things you decide to broadcast to the public. She goes out at night to find stories and stuff to broadcast. The other people, this guy, he's the actual radio host. So he tells, you choose what to tell people. Military is threatening to kill us, trying to intimidate us. All the more reason to repeat that we will keep telling you truth no matter what. And let's hope for the best. For this one round, we actually started with a lot of materials. So it started us with this water filter for clean water. There's a lot of food here, or a decent amount of food at least. We're trying to get to this portion of the house because there's more materials with all the hands and stuff. Also, since these two characters are smokers, in order to keep them mentally happy, they use roll-up cigarettes or like quality cigarettes to keep themselves happy. Game where you can win, or is it just continuous survival? It's mainly continuous survival. So in the classic game mode, this is the story DLC. So like, it's still the same thing where you're trying to survive, but there's an end point where, the story finishes. In the classic game mode, you're just trying to survive until the end of the war. So you're literally just trying to make it to the war. Typically ends in the classic mode from any day from 20 to 50. So those are the amount of days, and you start out just like with whatever preset characters you choose, or you can choose one of the ones that they already you can choose the own characters that you want to start with, what time of the year you want to start, because when winter comes, that's when this the dial up here really starts to matter. So, and then it gets more difficult because then people get sick and stuff like that. But you can choose one of their preset, like two or three characters, or you can choose your own and kind of like build your own story. But the classic game mode is to survive the war. You choose who goes on guard at night, who goes to sleep, who's going to go out and scavenge. If you read on the radio or you hear on the radio that burglars are out a lot, then you might want to keep everyone home to guard the place. That way, if you do get raided, you can fend them off. Different characters have different perks and cons. She's really good at sneaking. And the other character thing is she's a smoker and abstinent. Same thing with the other guy. They're both smokers. So if they have cigarettes, they'll stay happy. If somebody gets to the point where they're depressed, then they can become broken. And then if they become broken, they can't do anything. So there's different... There's a lot of different scenarios that you can either create or choose yourself. So this is what happens at night. You choose the night. Do you want to go out to a place or do you want to stay in and guard? Typically, majority of the time, I usually go out and scavenge anybody. If we had one other person, I would have them guard and then switch between the two, but we don't, so. So playing like Battlefield, Skyrim, Civ, Wolfenstein, but I enjoy strategic games and I'm wondering if this would be a good suitable game. The idea of it looks really good. So, like, you know how I just said, this is usually, like, not, typically not really the type of game I would play? I'm in your scenario, where I play Battlefield, I play Skyrim. Civ really isn't my game, but I've played it a few times. Wolfenstein, like, I play third-person games, RPGs, things like that. So, it'll be on a Switch Lite. That means anything. Yeah, so this is, I personally saw this on Switch the other day. I'm playing on PC, but I think this is a perfect Switch game, because if you have your Switch on you, yeah, you can play anytime you want. But if you go out places, even if your session ends, you can still start a new one, and you're just going to be starting with new characters. There's so much replay value in this game that, like, it's perfect for something that's portable, like a Switch. So I think, I don't know what the price is and stuff. You can get it really cheap on PC, but if you got it on Switch too, it's definitely, like, it's 100% portable, and it's something that you'll be able to play over and over again and have different outcomes each time. Also, if you make it to the end of the war, there's good, bad, and neutral endings for almost all the characters too. So depending on their situation, how they're feeling, how they did throughout the war, how long they survived, everything is kind of taken into effect, and it comes up with what happens. So like when you finish, it tells you, okay, say this scenario, like Malik went on to, he survived the war and started as radio host again, and continued, and Esma did the same thing. Or if you get like a bad ending, I don't know what the endings for this scenario is, but there's a lot of different scenarios. A lot of different things can happen. For sure. I'm wondering if it's worth going back without that saw blade. It says there are lots of materials. We can, yeah, I'll go back because there's a lot of materials. I'll bring the lockpick this time. Yeah, I actually didn't even think about that. I mean, I don't really go, if I traveled a lot more, I would play my Switch a lot more. I do have some games on my Switch, but if Switch was like my main platform, then I would definitely be bringing this game or buying it or playing it a lot. Because there's a lot that can happen. But it's also a very good, like, I normally don't play side-scrollers like this. Like, I like RPG games. The reason I picked it up is because I saw that it was more of a choices matter type thing. You decide the fate of what happens to other characters. You can be somebody who doesn't steal, and you try to get by just scavenging things, or you can be somebody that you don't care, you're looking out for yourself, so you're gonna steal and kill whoever you need to just to survive. Hey, that's the one thing that I love about this game. There's so many different ways you can play it, and with so many different characters too, whether it's good or bad. Nice. I'm gonna drop the sugar. Actually, I'll drop this because it's only one. And I'll take that. Let me just make sure there's nothing else. Oh, but there's something in here. Wood and components is kind of my priority. So I'll take that. The books, I think I'll keep. Same thing with the part. I can drop the shotgun shells. Okay, I think that's good. Let me just read this one more time. Yeah, there's not really any information. I think we're good here. We can't really do anything else unless if we had the saw blade. Then we could go here, but we can't. And into that basement. There's definitely something in that basement. There's gotta be. Oh, we got it. We got the materials, or most of the materials we need. And then the next night we can go to the other location and see if there's anything to broadcast from there. Thanks, appreciate the help. Yeah, no problem, my man. My man. I hope, I suggest it. I've been really enjoying this game. So, if you enjoyed it or anything I said helped, definitely I would recommend picking it up. Because I really think it is a great game. Alright, I'm gonna see if I can. I don't know if we have a stove. Yeah, we don't, so. Let's try to make one. Yeah, right there. He's very hungry. Sad and very tired. Ah, got something nice. There we go. So you found something to broadcast, I think. Or he found some information on a place that we might be able to go visit. Uh-oh. Ugh. She's so tired.
I'm coming.
Almost there.
All right.
Jeez. I wanted to tell you, Mel, you better watch what he says on the radio. Pissing off army is unwise. Think about it. You don't want a death squad at your door, do you? That's it. That's all he meant to say. Oh my gosh. I kind of want to look. I'm scared to broadcast too much. The last broadcast tips. Let's see. Make sure that you use and listen to your broadcast system every day and post every news. Okay. The achievement should pop up before Malik gets... Uh-oh. Wait, really? Wait, what? That's a spoiler. I'm not reading that out loud. No way. Be sure to visit every location and room to avoid missing news. What achievement is this? Huh. So there's three scenarios, choice options in this, supposedly. We can't really say anything right now. Interesting. All right, we'll just see how it plays out then. What's going on? So right now I'm trying to make food for both of them because they're very, well, she is very tired and hungry. He is very hungry. So I like to, you can feed them when they get hungry, but I think it's better to save it and do it when they get very hungry, because otherwise you're gonna be using a lot of food very quickly. She's very tired, so I'm letting her rest. He's about to eat something though, so he'll be good. Fight to the last breath. All right, let's end the day.
Okay. Scavenge. All right, so we gotta go to the park because we still don't have the weapon for the other location. I think I'll bring the... What happened to my lockpick? Did it break? I guess it might have broke. It seems so peaceful here. I don't know how to reach that place. All right, let's go down here then. See if there's anything down here. Oh, can't go up in there. We really need a saw blade this time around. Can she climb up there? Okay, she can. Cool. Try going over here now. So this is like a house that burnt down, I guess. Nice, there's a saw blade. Whoa, we just heard some shots. Oh god. Is that a sniper? Please come down here and help me. I see why they gave us the saw blade. Please help me, I don't want to go back through the park. This item is broken. Damn sniper is shooting people there. You want to get through the park, be careful. The main alley is under sniper fire. Are you sure? Go see for yourself. You might get through if you're fast, but it's risky as hell. Thanks, I need to be absolutely sure. That is so sketchy. I mean, we can hear the sniper fire from here. Shot the main alley is under sniper fire. Shot two people already. God. Oh man. I hope there's an exit. If you die, do you lose? You do. So like in the classic mode, yes. If you die, like it's over. But in this mode, since this is like a story-based version, if you die, it usually just takes you back to the day before. So that way you don't have to like redo the entire thing. Okay, there's a bunch of materials here, which is good. Can I get over there? Oh god, I'm scared. Okay, I was gonna say. I was worried how she was gonna get over here. Okay, so if we had a lockpick, we'd be able to get inside that. Nice, okay, good. I wanna run. Pass message on to Malik. Day 5.
Very bad news.
Night was calm. Learned that a sniper is shooting at people in the main park alley. I passed the news to Malik so he can warn the listeners. Alright, so she's very tired. Can we upgrade the workbench? Let's see. Yes, we can. Alright, good. Let's have him go listen. And then we'll have him broadcast afterwards. She's upgrading the workbench so that way I can see if we can make the saw blade. If we can, then I'll have her make that. Nice. Okay. Yeah, I kind of want to make two, so that way we have one in storage. And then after we make these two, I think we'll have her go to sleep. Let's see if we can make the traps, the food traps. Doesn't look like it. Can't upgrade it either. Okay. She can go rest. All right. So play as melee. Now, what will we broadcast? Oh, so we have two of them. Residents, make sure to avoid, no longer safe from snipers. Several people have already been shot. Rebel and government forces are engaged in violent skirmishes throughout the city. Some areas have been completely cut off while others are seeing heavy fighting. All right, let's do the story related one. Can you do both? Okay, you can't. Now you want to get to shoot anyone else, motherfucker. I had a brush with death in the park, but I'm alive. Others were less fortunate. Someone's at the door. Let's see. I mean, I don't know if we really want to trade anything right now, but maybe. Let's make a deal. You got any information? Yeah, coffee is becoming impossible to get. Word is that there won't be any deliveries until next air a drop. What will that be? Nobody knows, so the price is going to soar. Okay, thanks. Nice. Can we have them broadcast that too? I wonder. Alright, so he has cigarettes. And vegetables. Can you kill them? I think the traders you can. I'm pretty sure for the traders you can actually kill them, if I remember correctly. I never tried though. That's what I'll say. Fertilizer? Or should I take the herbs? I might take the herbs. What about coffee? Nope. Raw food? Nope. Where is that? There it is. Alright, deal. Alright, let's have a rest now. How can the army terrorize innocent civilians? Late sniper, I hope the rebels get him. Oh, so we can broadcast all these. Oh, that's awesome. Oh, I didn't know that you could broadcast all of them. I thought it was only going to be like one at a time. Sweet. Let's end the day. Okay. Let's go back to the house. And this time, I'm taking one saw blade with me. There's got to be some information here. I don't know what it is, but this house has got me interested. Which is why I've came back here like 3 or 4 times now. That red light. I feel like it's like a spy. Jeez. It's a lot of stuff there. They really made it worth your while. What else is here? Okay. Put the gunpowder away. Take the parts. Take the parts instead. Yeah. All right. Let's run to exit. Okay. Well, I guess there's not actually isn't anything here. So we'll have to get to a new location next time. But I'm still glad that we at least came here. She's hungry too, so she's probably going to be very hungry once we get back to the place. We didn't really get any news. But there might be some. And waiting for us at least. Day 6. I haven't learned anything of note. Okay. She's very hungry now too. Is he very hungry too? Yep. Okay. All right, we need fuel. Wrong one. Where is it? This guy. Two of them should be good. Up here. Make the 2 meals. And then she'll eat. I'm gonna let him rest, or her rest, and see if we can do, finish, or get this to like 1/4 of the way there. Huh. I just realized, too, this ground floor one only lets you get to this. But the top floor lets you get to everything else. Damn. I think I'd rather do the top floor one then. Actually. Okay. E8, let's have him listen to the radio. And then once she wakes up, she's only tired, so she shouldn't have to sleep for too long. Once she wakes up, though, I'll have her get started on this one. Rather do this one first compared to the bottom one. Aha, I got something. Nice, nice. Whoops. Nobody's at the door. All right, nice. He's done sleeping. Transmission captured. She's gonna get tired soon. Received. C23, can you hear me? That dim radio broadcast compromised my position and people stopped using the route to the park. Someone should do something about that rogue broadcaster. Over. Oh boy. Oh man. You seen my glasses? No, I haven't. I don't know if she'll wake back up again. I don't know how long she sleeps for. I guess we can time it, right? We put her to sleep at like 4:10. Wants to listen to some good music. Sounds like a radio. This game kind of makes me want to play Papers, Please, which I need to do that sometime soon, but I don't know when I'm going to. I think the next game, once I finish all these DLCs, I think I'm going to start my playthroughs of GTA, because I really need to play. I'm urging or itching to play a third person story cinematic game. I've been wanting to play okay, so it takes about 2 hours. What is Papers, Please? It's basically you play as trying to think of the words, how to explain it. You play as a security guard in like the 1960s or 80s for, I think the place is called like Urzikstan or something like that. And basically people come up, like it's another similar to, not similar to this, but it's like another indie game. But basically people come up and they have a picture of themselves, like in the bottom left, and you have to look at their papers and make sure that things match up. So like their ID has to match their passport, And then if not, then you can like be like, there's a tool that you can use and be like, hey, what's going on with this here? And then they'll be like, oh, and then you choose whether you accept or deny them through. And some people will be terrorists. Some people will be like just somebody trying to get through. Some people will be innocent. The more people you let through, the more money you make by the end of the day. But if you mess up, then money can be taken away from you. And then at the end of the... So at the end of the day, once you're done with everybody choosing who goes through and who doesn't, then it takes you back to your house and you just have like a thing and it shows you, okay, this is how much money you made today. How much do you want to put towards your family? And it's like, you can, sometimes your wife will get sick, your mother-in-law will get sick, your daughter. So you have to choose, okay, if they're hungry, who am I going to feed? Who needs medicine? Do I need to feed myself? Like, it's kind of another similar situation, like when you go home and then you go out to work and then you go home. So it's like that, but it's a part of it is like a top down game in a way, because you can see the line of people waiting to go through the border. But then in the bottom left hand corner, that's where you see the person, like when the person walks up, that's, you see them, you see their papers, and then you just have to verify that they are who they say they are to let them through. It's another one of those games where it has multiple endings, multiple different scenarios, random scenarios. It's pretty cool. Yeah, you literally are, or pretty much are customs. There's another game that's similar to it, but it's kind of like, it's like a third person game, and it has a little bit more freedom, but it doesn't have as many good reviews, called Border Officer, where it's the same thing, but it's a first person game. And like, you literally, like, you start out in your little shack of a house, and you drive to work, and then you decide who goes through, and then you drive back home. It's an interesting game. It's kind of like Internet Cafe Simulator and things like that too. They're all like little indie games, but they're interesting in my opinion. So I don't know which one to go to. City Center used to be beautiful with parks, squares, and mountains, all surrounded up by old buildings. War is taking its toll on the area, or the warehouse, big store. Currently, it's used as a hideout by a group of armed thugs. I'd find some useful things there if we can sneak in, but it's very dangerous. All right, let's go to Central Square first. I'm not gonna take anything, I guess. Trade goes on even during the war. Statues like this remind me of there's blood on the ground. Something happened here recently. There's something underneath us. There are soldiers nearby. I really need to get a knife. Or build one at least. Nobody down here, which is good. I don't know why, but this game sort of makes me want to play Wolfenstein as well, or even Metro.
which I might do that.
I want to replay
the first two Metro games and then Metro Exodus. Because I play them on Xbox, but I never played them on PC. I feel like they might run better. New information gain. Okay. Oh god. Just finished Wolfenstein 2. I haven't played it yet, but it's been one of those games that I've wanted to play for a while. It's a great game. We played Zelda Breath of the Wild. It's Signal Bagel. No, I haven't. Well, so I did. Actually, in talking to sleep, I'd have took him for dead. I'm afraid. Should I go through? I played some of it, but I couldn't finish it. I'm gonna try it. I don't know if this is a good idea. Nothing but useless trash. I think somebody's coming in behind me. Soldiers locked us up here. Called Bagel to their rebel supporters. Keep asking us about our contacts among the rebels. We don't know anything. I can't click through this. Oh, pause. Wait, you can pause it like that? I didn't know that. Interesting. Yeah, so Breath of the Wild, I have it on Switch, but I couldn't finish it. It's really, like, I don't know. It's not really my type of game. But I did try it and everything. I did my best. All right, I'm gonna see if I can get out of here now. Yeah, like first person shooters and third person like RPG games, things like that are typically my type of games. Those are really what I play most. Something like this, it's kind of like, it's something I usually wouldn't play, but it interested me enough where I wanted to. Nothing beats Skyrim in my opinion. Now I hear that. Another game that I want to play, but that's one of the games that I want to like be able to play a lot of the side quests and stuff too. I've discovered that the army is torturing some people suspected of helping the rebels. They'll most likely be killed if they're not rescued soon. All right, so we gotta push that out on the radio. But I think some of my closer games that I'm trying to do. So I never played GTA 3, Vice City, or San Andreas. I've had all of them for so long, but I've never fully played any all the way through and finished the story. So once I finish this game and the two DLCs, I'm most likely going to be starting GTA 3, play that, then Vice City, then San Andreas, then GTA 4, and then GTA 4's DLC, and then GTA 5. I kind of want to play them all in a row, so that way they're done and over with, and then go on to a new franchise.
So that's pretty much what I have planned for the next few weeks. Most likely after this. You haven't played Skyrim? No, I played Skyrim. I played it back on like Xbox and stuff when I originally released. That's another one of the games. Like, there's certain games that I want to replay on PC because they can have such different experiences. In my opinion. So, yeah, no, I played Skyrim, and I love that game. I never played Oblivion though, so I don't know. Part of me wants to play Oblivion 2 at some point. But I don't know if I 100% will. I actually have Skyrim VR too. And I have Fallout 4 VR. Another game that I want to play. I want to play all the Fallouts from 3 New Vegas and 4. Again too on PC. I play them all on console. And some of the DLCs. I don't know what to have her do. Never played Oblivion. How's the VR? Fallout is good too. Yeah, I do love those games. So VR, I actually did start. What was it? Not Fallout VR, but I started Skyrim VR for literally like a day. Basically it's interesting. It's pretty cool. I started Skyrim DLC or the Skyrim VR, and it's so weird starting the game and you're literally sitting in the van or the wagon in the beginning, and you're just sitting there and you look to your right and the one guy is there. I think it was the peasants to your right. But then you look in the corners. I forget which corner it is, but you see what's the guy? The storm guy. I can't remember his name. Shoot. The king or whatever. It's weird, but it's funny. And like you can like sit there and move your hands like and touch their face and stuff. It's pretty cool though. That's one of the games like I kind of want to play it normally, but then I want to play it in VR too, because that would be so much fun. And then like when you're about to get executed, it's so weird because like they put your head on the thing, but you're still sitting straight, but you can still like look around and see like the entire world. And like when the dragon comes down, like it's huge because it's in VR. So it all looks very, very, really cool. That's a great game to have in VR mode. Same thing with like Fallout, because those games you can play for like almost forever and still have more stuff to do. Real quick, I'm going to run to the bathroom again and fill up some water. So I will be right back in a minute or two. And then we can keep playing and talking. BRB.